Greetings, grade 12. We'll be continuing the chapter that is reproductive health. We are at the fourth session, infertility and art. We talked about different methods, that is the contraception methods. We also talked about sexually transmitted diseases. Now we are going to see what is infertility and what are various methods by which it can be rectified. So, infertility is the inability of male or female to produce children. And it's very important to note down what is written on your screen, that is to get pregnant after at least 1 year of trying. That means without the participation or role of any of the contraception devices, and having healthy relationship with your partner and still you did not get pregnant for say a year, then only it is considered as infertile. And the reason for this may be physical, congenital, diseases, drugs, immunological or even psychological. So all various factors are there. And if I talk about pregnancy, it's not it's not a very simple procedure. The egg has to be released in a proper way. We have seen how the various stages are there in which ovulation happens. We have in the female body, again, the hormones have to be produced in a proper amount and at the proper time period. In the male's body, the sperms have to be healthy enough. They have to get the proper nutrition, their mobility have to be in a proper way. The egg must go through the fallopian tube towards the uterus, at the ampulla and isthmus junction. Again, the sperm must join and fertilize. It should be successful to fertilize. Again, the fertilization process, we have seen that how the acrosome of the sperm is producing the enzyme to lyse or to break the zona pellucida, that's the layer of the ovums. All these things have to be in a synchronized way. And even if the fertilization happened, it's very important for the implantation to happen. That is, you know that how the zygote will go on to the different stages, morula, then blastocyst, and then the blastocyst, the outer layer, has to attach with the uterine wall, and that is what is implantation. That is what forms the placenta. So all these things have to happen step by step without any complication. Then only the pregnancy can be achieved. So if any of these processes is interrupted due to many reasons included, then the woman is not able to, if there is a problem with the sperm, say sperm production, number of sperm, the viability of the sperm inside the female reproductive system, or say the motility of the sperm. So then it is the male infertility. So you have various, you have both the concerns are there, the female infertility conditions are there, male infertility conditions are there. So with that, we'll go ahead. Now, what are things or what are the technologies that has been developed to compact this infertility or to come through, or what are the things that have helped the couples or say the men and women in order to get pregnant and to achieve pregnancy. So here the very first thing that you have to know is it is called as ART, A-R-T. So it is assisted reproductive technology. And in this, you'll have various different terms that I'll be using, and various methods we'll be explaining it to you. So when I talk about ART, it is a combination of various methods that are used to help the infertile couple to achieve pregnancy. In a simple way, you can understand this. Now, even very simple terminologies like the test tube baby or the in vitro fertilization is also a form of ART. So ART involves removing eggs from the woman's body, mixing them with the sperm in the laboratory and putting the embryo back into the woman's body. Now this can be done at various stages, and that is how it has been categorized further. Now, when you look at your screen now, you can see the various methods. You can see IVF. I hope we all know what is IVF, that is in vitro fertilization that happens inside the lab. As I explained you just now, that the ova is taken out from female, sperm is taken out from male, the fertilization happens outside, that is in the laboratory, and then the embryo is transferred. So that is one way. You have another, that is GIFT or gamete intrafallopian transfer. You have one more, zygote intrafallopian transfer. So you can just understand that gamete intrafallopian, only gamete I'm going to transfer. So definitely a male gamete is being transferred inside the female fallopian tube so that the fertilization happens. Whereas the third one that you see, the zygote. So the zygote is developed outside and then the zygote is implanted inside the fallopian tube or kept inside the fallopian tube, and then the morula process or the blastocyst, everything has to happen, and then the implantation have to happen. Intrauterine inseminization, in that directly the sperm is allowed along with the semen. So the whole semen is allowed inside the uterus. So how the normal copulation happens without the penis, the whole thing will be injected inside. So that is the one IUI, that is intrauterine inseminization. And then you have intracytoplasmic sperm injection. So directly inside the ova, inside the cytoplasm of ova, the sperm is being injected. So you have different way, we'll be seeing one by one. Okay, talking about the in vitro fertilization, as already I have explained it to you, it is a test tube baby program. Is in the normal way, this is what we say. And in this method, ova from the wife or donor, it can be anything, and sperms from the husband or donor again are collected and are induced to form zygote under stimulated conditions in the laboratory. So these are the controlled condition in which fertilization is happening, and this is followed by embryo transfer. And again, embryo transfer can be of two types. One is zygote intrafallopian transfer and one is intrauterine transfer. When I talk about the zygote intrafallopian transfer, that is ZIFT, Z-I-F-T, ZIFT. So zygote intrafallopian transfer, in this we transfer zygote or early embryos up to only 8 blastomeres. So it should not be more than 8 number of cells, and that is being transferred into the fallopian tube. Okay, whereas the second one, that is intrauterine transfer, the transfer of embryos with more than 8 blastomeres into the uterus, the embryo formed by in vivo fertilization, that is fertilization within the female, is also used for such transfer to assist those females who cannot conceive. So in vitro fertilization is what is happening in the lab, and in vivo fertilization is what happens inside the female body. So in both the things, you can go for intrauterine transfer. Okay, so is it clear? I talked about IVF, and in that I talked about that how the under the controlled condition the fertilization happens. After the fertilization happens, for embryo transfer you have two types, ZIFT and IUT. ZIFT is zygote intrafallopian transfer and IUT is intrauterine transfer. On your screen, you can see how exactly it is being done. So that's a presentation for you. It will be easy for you to understand, and what are the significances also given on your screen. Now, I talked about ZIFT just now, so it's very clear again given on your screen. Talking about the second one, that is gamete intrafallopian transfer, that is GIFT. So we talked about ZIFT, we talked about IUT, we talked about IVF. Now I'm talking about GIFT, that is GIFT. Now in GIFT, transfer of an ovum from a donor into the fallopian tube of another female who cannot produce ovum but can provide suitable environment for fertilization and development. So ovum is not being produced by the mother, but yes, it can be after implantation, that is the growth of the baby is being done, or it can happen inside the uterus. So that is what is gamete intrafallopian transfer. So the ovum is from a donor is kept inside the fallopian tube. So this is for the mothers whose ovum is not appropriate or cannot participate for fertilization. Now you can see the whole mechanism on your screen, how exactly that is using a catheter. Catheter is a small tube-like structure which is used normally for a lot of medical procedures. So with that, they keep or they place the sperm and the egg inside the fallopian tube. So this is what is GIFT. Okay, now talking about intracytoplasmic sperm injection. Again, on your screen, you can have the clear visuals what exactly is happening. It's a laboratory procedure in which a single sperm from male partner is injected directly into an egg of from a female partner, and then the fertilized egg is implanted into the woman's uterus. So this is, we are not keeping it on a condition that maybe fertilization will happen or not, but we are making fertilization to happen. And again, the chances of all these are 50-50, or again, there are some complications that even though this all things are done outside, but still there are few things that your body accepts or not, or implantation will happen or not. So all those natural mechanisms will interfere. Now, when you look at your screen now, you can see the various methods. You can see IVF. I hope we all know what is IVF. That is in vitro fertilization that happens inside the lab. As I explained to you just now, that the ova is taken out from female, sperm is taken out from male. The fertilization happens outside, that is in the laboratory, and then the embryo is transferred. So that is one way. You have another, that is GIFT or gamete intrafallopian transfer. You have one more, zygote intrafallopian transfer. So you can just understand that gamete intrafallopian, only gamete I'm going to transfer. So definitely a male gamete is being transferred inside the female fallopian tube so that the fertilization happens. Whereas the third one that you see, the zygote. So the zygote is developed outside and then the zygote is implanted inside the fallopian tube. Now, part we have discussed. So donor's egg or donor's sperm, previously frozen embryos, all these things, even the sperms can be stored in a frozen conditions. It is sometimes used when the woman or man has a genetic disorder and there is a chance that it can be passed to the baby. So in that case, again, the donor sperms or the donor egg can be used. Okay, now there is one point that I have not included in my slide, that is surrogacy, and I hope we all know or we have discussed plenty of time about it. So surrogacy is a woman, that is a surrogate mother, bears a child for a couple and the couple is unable to produce children because the wife is infertile or is unable to carry. So here this female gives her womb for the proper development of the baby. So surrogate is impregnated either through artificial insemination or through implantation of an embryo produced by an in vitro fertilization. So either of the case, these all things can go. So, but we have some problems with ART, like it requires high precision handling by specialized professional and expensive instrumentation. That is one drawback. Therefore, these facilities are available only in few centers. And emotional, religious and social problem. Yes, it's very difficult for to make, you know, people understand that it's the whole science behind. Then legal adoption is one of the best methods for couples who are looking for parenthood if they don't want to undergo all these conditions. So with that, I end the chapter, reproductive health. We have seen every aspect of the chapter. If any doubts, you know what you have to do. And the worksheet for the last two sessions along with the questions and whatever you have to write as a notes will be coming shortly to you. Thank you.